adding with base 10 models.
Today we're going to practice solving some addition problems using the base 10 blocks and by drawing pictorial models. Just to review from our previous videos, these blocks represent ones and we draw them with a small dot. These blocks represent tens and we draw them with a line. And these blocks represent hundreds and we draw them with a square. We're going to start by solving this problem, 43 plus 26 equals something. The first step for students is to model the number 43. 43 has four tens and three ones. After they model the first number, they should always count to make sure they have the correct amount. 10, 20, 30, 40, 41, 42, 43. I then like to draw a line before modeling my next number just to organize my model. After I model 43, I have to model 26 as well. 26 has two tens and six ones. Once again, I want to check to make sure that the model I have is correct. 10, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26. After I've modeled both quantities, I'm ready to count to find the total. I always start by counting my ones first. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 ones. After I count my ones, I count my tens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 tens. When I'm finished, I like to count the whole model just to make sure that my addition was correct. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69. The total of 43 and 26 is 69. Now let's solve this problem by drawing a pictorial model. The first thing students will need to do is to make an HTO chart on their paper. They need three columns labeled with an O for the ones, a T for the tens, and an H for the hundreds. I start by drawing 43. I'm going to draw 43 with four tens and three ones. Once again, I separate my quantities and then I model 26. When I'm ready to count, I will start in my ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Write a 9 in the ones place, and I count my tens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 tens, the total is 69. Let's try another one. How about 56 plus 28 equals something. I start by modeling 56 with five tens. Three, four, five tens and six ones. Two, three, four, five, six, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56. I model 28 more, 10, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. After I have modeled both quantities, I'm ready to start counting my ones. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 ones. I have 14 ones. That means I need to compose a 10. When you have 10 or more ones, you need to put 10 ones together to make a new 10. So what I'm going to do is make a trade. I'm going to count out 10 ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. These 10 ones, if they were put together, would look exactly like the tens blocks. So they are the same as 1 10. And by making a trade, I'm just changing the way they look from 10 ones into 1 10. After I group the ones, I have to move it into the tens place. I then count the ones that I have remaining, which is 1, 2, 3, 4. After I count my ones and I count my tens, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So the total should be 84, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84. Now let's see what that problem would look like with a pictorial model. We make our HTO chart, ones, tens, hundreds. I model 56, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56. I model 28, 10, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. I count my ones, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. I have to compose a 10. When I compose a 10 in my model, what I'm going to do is circle 10 ones to show that I'm putting them together to make a new 10. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'm going to circle these 10 ones to show that I'm grouping them together to form a new 10. I then draw an arrow into the tens place, and right in front of that arrow, I draw the 10 that I am making from those 10 ones. I count the remaining ones that I have, and I record the total there, 4, and then I count my tens. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Don't forget to include that new 10 in your total, 84. Now let's try a problem that has some hundreds in it. Let's see how we can solve 238 plus 107. 238 starts off with 2 hundreds. So I need to get my big hundreds blocks out. And I need 3 tens. 1, 2, 3. And 8 ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I want to make sure I have the correct amount. 100, 200, 210, 220, 230. 231, 232, 233, 234, 235, 236, 237, 238. And I model 107 with 100. There are no tens in 107, so I leave my tens place empty, and I still need 7 ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107. Once again, I always start by counting my ones first. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 ones. So I need to compose a 10. I need to group 10 ones together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'm going to trade these 10 ones for a new 10 because they are the same, they have the same value, and I move that new 10 into the tens place. I then count the remaining ones, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Count my tens, 1, 2, 3, 4 tens, and I have to count my hundreds, 1, 2, 3 hundreds. So the total should be 345. 100, 200, 300, 310, 320, 330, 340, 341, 342, 343, 344, 345, 345. Let's check our work by drawing a pictorial model. My ones, my tens, my hundreds. I model 238. Remember, we'd use squares to show hundreds. 100, 200, 210, 220, 230, 231, 232, 233, 234, 235, 236, 237, 238. Separate my quantities. 107 is 100. No tens, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107. I count my ones. I had 8 here. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 in all. So I need to compose a 10. I use 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 ones to compose my 10. I circle those to show that they're being grouped together. And then I draw an arrow into my tens place to show that I'm moving them and forming a new 10. I still have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 ones. I have 1, 2, 3, 4 tens. And 1, 2, 3 hundreds. The total is 345. Let's solve one more problem together today. Our last problem today will be 345 plus 176. I'm going to model 345 first using 1, 2, 3 hundredths blocks, 4 tens, and 5 ones. 100, 200, 300, 310, 320, 330, 340, 341, 342, 343, 344, 345. I need to model 176 next with 100, 7 tens, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 6 ones. 1, 2, 100, 110, 120, 130, 140, 150, 160, 170, 171, 172, 173, 174, 175, 176. I'm going to begin by counting my ones first. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I have 11 ones, so I need to compose a 10 using 10 ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. These 10 ones can form a new 10, so I'm going to group them together and make my trade for my new 10, which gets put into my tens place. I still have 1 in the ones place. Have to count my tens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I have 12 tens. If I count those by 10, I realize that 12 tens is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 110, 120. 12 tens has a value of 120, so I need to compose 100. I need to group 10 tens together to form a new 100. 1 ten, 2 tens, 3 tens, 4 tens, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. If I put these 10 tens together, it forms a 100s block. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. So I group my 10 tens and I trade it for a 100s block, which gets moved into the 100s place. I count my remaining tens. There are 2. And then I count my 100s. 100, 200, 300, 400, 500. So the total is 521. 100, 200, 300, 400, 500, 510, 520, 521. Let's check that with a model, a pictorial model. Ones, tens, hundreds. I model 345 with 300s. 310, 320, 330, 340, 341, 342, 343, 344, 345. Separate my quantities, 100, 110, 120, 130, 140, 150, 160, 170, 171, 172, 173, 174, 175, 176. I count my ones, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I have 11, so I have to compose a 10 with 10 ones, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I circle those 10 ones, and remember to draw my arrow into the tens place and make my new 10 there. I still have one in the ones place. I count my tens, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I have to compose 100, so I have to circle 10 tens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Circle these 10 tens. And I draw my arrow into the hundreds place and make a new 100 there. I still have two tens in the tens place. And then I count my hundreds, 100, 200, 300, 400, 500. The total is 521. And that is how you use base 10 blocks and pictorial models to add within 1,000.